Hello everyone, today we the concerned students of class 11D are here to present a special assembly on the topic Fix the Basics First, which is based on the Sustainable Development Goal 9 set by the United Nations General Assembly in the year 2015. SDG 9 aims to build resilient infrastructure, promote sustainable industrialization and foster innovation. As explained by the UN, investments in infrastructure, transport, irrigation as well as communication technology are crucial in achieving sustainable development and empowering communities in many countries. It has long been recognized that growth in productivity, incomes and improvement in health education outcomes require investment in infrastructure. You know that 828 million people live in slums today and the number keeps rising.
People in this developing world are facing difficulty in accessing electricity full time.
1 to 1.5 billion people do not have access to reliable network services.
Infrastructure constraints reduce productivity to 40% in the developing world.
Underdeveloped infrastructure.
All multinational companies have their production spread over several other countries. They buy raw material from some country, make the final finished product from that raw material in some other country, and then sell the finished valuable product at high prices in some other countries. They try to keep their cost of production very low and the similarly profits very high. Therefore, they try to buy labor with minimum pay. This is a story about Vijayanti, a worker at an MNC factory in a small village of Kerala. She is a daily wage worker and works continuously without any rest. She does not get any holiday, and if she misses even a single day at work, she does not get pay for that day. Her job is dependent upon the whims of the employer and she does not get any job security.
My employer asks all the workers to work hard and produce quality products in bulk. Since much of his capital is spent in buying raw materials, he does not keep the needs of the workers into consideration. We are paid less than the minimum amount, and we have to work more than what our wages demand.
Now, let us look into another example that is opposite to the previous one and an ideal one.
I am Rama. I work in an office. My working hours are fixed, that is from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. I do not go to office on Sundays, that is, I have a paid holiday. I also get provident fund as per the rules laid by Government of India. I also get medical allowances. When I joined the work, I was given an appointment letter stating all the terms and conditions of work, that is, I have complete job security.
Do you see the differences in the work conditions between Rama and Vijayanti? Rama works in an organized sector where employees get paid regularly, have a good working environment, job security, as well as facilities such as medical and other allowances. Also, they have a fixed working hours. On the other hand, Vijayanti works in an unorganized sector whose biggest downfall is lack of job security. Also, people working in these sectors do not enjoy any such facilities that the people working in organized sector do. Now, let us consider another aspect, innovations.
Kamal's condition who made goods in the basket weaving industry set up in his home. Such industries are called cottage industries.
Earlier, people used to like the baskets made by me so much that they would buy so many from me and would also recommend my baskets to others. Even the tourists who used to visit our village would like them so much. But after the handicraft showroom that opened in our area, hardly anyone buys them. It is becoming very difficult for me to make a living.
As we have seen in the case of Kamal, many cottage industry workers, as well as street vendors, farmers and laborers are struggling hard for a living. With the arrival of industrialization and advancement in technology, such people hardly get recognition.
We want recognition of our jobs. We want better pay and employment opportunities. Punish our greedy MNCs and employers who always cares about their selfish benefits and not care for us and our families. We want justice.
Taking into consideration the workers' demands and sufferings as well as the unfair means used by the employers, the court, under the Minimum Wages Act, Shops and Establishment Act, thereby mandates for all the employers to fix the working hours for the workers and also give them regular paid wages and provide with them formal letters of formal documents of the jobs. Any employer who is found to pay any employee less than the minimum wage fixed for the work of that employee or less than the minimum wages fixed under the Minimum Wages Act shall be punishable with an imprisonment which may extend to 6 months or with a fine which may extend to 500 or with both under the clause of section 22 under Indian Penal Code.
Government of India has made many laws to improve the conditions of small-scale workers and unemployed citizens. This includes the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, MGNREGA 2005, that guarantees 100 days of work to the rural and urban poor. The Minimum Wages Act 1948 guarantees some minimum amount of wages that has to be paid by the employer to their workers. There are numerous ways in which the government can contribute to the fulfillment of SDG 9. This can be done by developing quality, sustainability and resilient infrastructure, increasing the access of small-scale industries and other enterprises to the financial services, supporting domestic technology development, research and innovations in underdeveloped and developing countries, as well as increasing their access to the communication services.
Government has taken some initiatives. The Bharat Broadband Network Limited is aiming to provide high-speed broadband connectivity to all the village councils in the country. Over the last 5 years, there has been a consistent growth in the installed electricity generation capacity. Further, India is making efforts to become an information technology and manufacturing hub through its Make in India campaign. And this campaign has greatly accelerated the foreign direct investment FDI inflows in the country. Additionally, the Startup India program guarantees entrepreneurship and labor-intensive economic growth. Our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has appealed to the country to become vocal for local and to support the small industries, especially in the time of crisis due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
And what can we as citizens do on our parts? Small deeds can make big differences. We can join pressure groups and participate in campaigns, shop local, support neighborhood businesses to reduce food miles traveled, write to local and national politicians to push for action, and share facts with family and friends to encourage actions.